Hey everyone, so in this video I just want to quickly show you how to create custom entities in the new beta version of Bedrock Edition and how to create a little basic animation. So let's get started. All Bedrock entities basically consist of two parts. One part is in the behavior pack and this is the server-side part, so it basically defines how the entity moves and how it interacts with the world. And the other part is the resource pack, which basically defines how the entity looks for the player. So I've created an empty world with one empty behavior pack and an empty resource pack. And to manifest the JSON files, which you can see here. So we're going to start with the behavior pack and we're going to create a new file inside the entities folder. And we're going to call the file clock.json and save it in that folder. And now this is important, we need to define the format version of all the files. The tag of this version is 1.8.0 beta.1. And we're going to define a new entity. And here we're going to start with the description tag. And here we basically define the identifier and spawnex and stuff like that. So we're going to name the entity tutorial:clock. And we're going to define a new spawn egg and set its value to true. So let me just copy this tag. Now we're going to say is summonable, so it gets its own summon command. And we're also going to set it to is experimental. And now I want to add a quick physics component. So we got to open the components tag, add a new component Minecraft:physics. And we're going to set gravity to true. Okay, so let's see how this looks in game. So we're going to load both our behavior and our resource pack. And just click continue here. And now this is very important, so make sure use experimental gameplay is enabled in the option. Okay, let's open the world. Let's try to summon a tutorial:clock. And as you can see, it worked, but we can't see the entity. So obviously we need to define how the entity looks in our resource pack. So let's go into our resource pack and we're going to create a new folder, call it entity, and inside entity we're going to define our clock entity. So we're going to call the file clock.json and save it in that folder. And now we obviously need our format version tag again, so let's define that real quick. And now we're going to define a new Minecraft client entity. So we want to set the identifier to tutorial:clock, the same as in the behavior pack. And let's also give it a spawn egg. And here we can actually define the colors of the spawn egg. So the base color is like the background color and the overlay color is like the little dots. And yeah, we could go into Blockbench and just pick the colors with a built-in color picker. So let's pick a nice white for the background. And just paste the code in there. Let's pick a black for the hand and put it here. So now we want to tell the game to render the entity. So we're going to create a new folder, call it render_controller. And inside that folder, create a new file. And you have guessed it, clock.json is the name. And again, we are going to define our format version. Let's just copy it from that file and paste it here. And so let's define our render controllers here. And we basically want to set all of this just to the default values. So we don't want to do anything special. So let's just name our render controller controller.render.clock. And we're going to define our geometry and set it to geometry.default. And do the same for our materials. Open a new array inside a compound and set our asterisk to material.default. And we're going to do the same for the texture. We're just going to set it to texture.default. Okay, so now we want to link our render controller inside our entity definition file. So we're going to copy the name and let's just close the other files here and go into that file, create a new tag for our render underscore controllers for the new array. And inside that array, you wanna just paste the name. So that's that. And now we need to take care of the model. So let's open Blockbench, create a new entity model. Gonna create a new group, call it main. Create a new cube inside that bone. And just gonna make like a really basic clock model. So gonna set it to maybe 2x10, 10 up, create a little axis in the front, set it to the center. Okay, so let's create a new bone for the hand and let's set its origin to the center of the clock. So it spins nicely around the center axis. Let's set it a bit to the front and yeah, that should do. Okay, let's create a texture, just enable template, confirm, and now pick the paintbrush, just a nice black color, set the mode to fill, and just fill in all the faces. And also the hand maybe. Alright. Okay, let's pick a nice bright color for the background of the clock, and set it to brush, set the radius to 2 to get a bit more effect. Just paint it all in. Okay, that should do. Let's give that little knob a bit of color there in the middle. Okay, so now make sure to set the geometry name of the mob. Just set it to geometry.clock maybe and export it as a Bedrock entity inside our resource pack, inside the folder models and entity. And we're gonna call it clock.json again. And we also need to save our texture, and we're gonna go into the resource pack folder again, textures folder, and create a new folder, call it entity, and inside there we are gonna save our clock texture as clock.png. So now our model is done, now we need to call it in our main file. So let's create a new geometry. And we're gonna set the default geometry to geometry.clock, which is basically what we defined in our project settings here. And we also need to call the texture, so just set the default texture again to the path of our texture, which is in our case textures. You can see it down here, textures slash entity slash clock. And you don't want that PNG there, so that might crash the game, so just leave it away. And we also need to define our materials, so just take the default materials again, and we're just gonna set it to entity, which is like a default setting. Okay, so I made a little mistake here, so all of this stuff needs to be inside of our description tag. So just create a little tag around it, and don't miss the last bracket, and just indent it a bit more. And that should do. Now let's see if our model works. Just open Minecraft, join the world, and we have our clock entities here. And as you can see, we also have a spawn deck here with the nice black and white colors, and we can use it to spawn other clock entities. But now we need to take care of the animation. So let's close the game again. Let's create a new folder, call it animations. And inside that folder, yes, you've guessed it, we create another file and call it clock.json, and gonna copy the format version line again, and we open our animations tag, and inside that animations tag, gonna create a new animation, call it animations.clock.spin, so this will be like our basic hand spin animation. We're gonna set loop to true so that it spins around and doesn't stop. Now we define our bones. So we're gonna call our hand bone, and this is basically, you need to make sure that this is the same name as in the model file. Okay, we're gonna set our rotation, and usually this is where you wanna define your keyframes. So you could set it to 0.5 and then define your rotation, but you don't wanna do that. So we're just gonna define our rotation array and set it to 0, 0, 0 for now. Okay, now to call the animation, let's copy the path of the animation and paste it into our main file again. So we're gonna define animations and we are gonna set our spin animation to our path from right before from that animation file. So now what we need to do is create an animation controller, which is basically a file that calls the animation and describes how and when the animation plays, and it also combines animations and stuff like that. Okay, so let's define a new animation controller, and I'm gonna call it always, and I'm gonna set it to controller.animation.clock.always. And now we need to create that file, so let's just copy the name and create a new folder, call it animation_controllers. Inside that folder, create a new file, and we're going to call it again clock.json, save it again, and copy our format version tag again. And here we're going to define our animation controllers. So inside animation controllers, we're going to define our new animation controller, which we just mentioned down here. And inside the states compound, we're going to set the default state. And in the default state, we are going to call the following animations. And we just got to call the spin animation. So now let's program our actual animation. So we can use fixed numbers for this, or we can use a new MoLang scripting language, which we can define inside the quotes right here. So for this, we are going to use the variable params.animTime, which is the time that the animation has been running for in seconds. Since we want the hand to move in steps, we want to get rid of any decimal numbers in between the full seconds. So we are going to use math.floor for this. And because it should spin around once every 60 seconds, we are going to tell it to move 6 degrees every second. Oh, and of course this has to be on the x-axis, not on the z-axis. Yeah, so let's check out if it's working. Just gonna open the world. Okay, and here we have all of our little clocks with their hands spinning around. So that's been it. I hope you could learn something from this video. And again, this was a very simple model. You can do much more. I tried to make it as simple as possible. Basically show the least amount of code that you can make a custom entity with an animation with. Yeah, of course, with this technique, you can create anything moving, like cars and dragons and leaves rustling in the wind and giant machines. Okay, anyways, thanks for watching and bye.